4 years ago yesterday, the Carnival Magic cruise ship made one of the most infamous port calls in our island's history. The ship dropped anchor outside the designated anchorage zone, destroying 16,000 square feet of healthy coral reef. Cayman 27's Joe Avery looks back at the incident and the two-year volunteer effort to repair the damage.
Wednesday, August 27, 2014. Staffers at Don Foster's Dive Cayman captured video of the Carnival Magic's chain and anchor destroying a coral reef in front of their dive shop.
The anchor itself was massive, and you could see the scar where it dug in and pulled right across the reef. It was really sad to see, actually.
By the time the Carnival Magic steamed off to its next port of call, more than 16,000 square feet of coral reef were left in ruins.
It's going to be hard dealing with anything beyond the 70-foot mark.
Weeks later, volunteers had received the green light from Department of Environment officials to undertake a restoration effort that stretched on for 2 years. Carnival Cruise Lines eventually coughed up a $100,000 donation to partially finance the restoration without admitting fault.
Rome wasn't built in a day, and this isn't going to be done in a day or 10 days or 20 days. It's going to be long term.
4 years later, the scar from the anchor impact is still evident, but many reattached corals are now thriving in the restoration zone. In deeper areas of the site, algae has taken advantage of the absence of coral, attracting these territorial damselfish, who made it clear our cameras are not welcome near their new homes.
Now the DOE in its report on the Carnival Magic incident called it an unfortunate accident with responsibilities shared by three parties, the Port Authority, the Carnival Magic, and Baden Shipping, none of which were ever prosecuted or held financially responsible for the damage. In Georgetown, Joe Avery, Cayman 27.
In the 4 years since the Carnival Magic incident, other ships have damaged Cayman's reefs in high-profile cases, most notably the Saga grounding at Eden Rock in late 2016 and the January 2016 incident involving billionaire Paul Allen's mega yacht Tatush.